At the outset, I thank Professor Pandav and the IOSC for giving an opportunity. And I'll be speaking out how to choose a glaucoma drainage implant, and we don't have any financial interest to disclose. So as talked by previous speaker, recently the glaucoma drainage implant have been increasingly doing for various types of glaucoma, and there is a significant shift in the practice towards the implant in eyes had previous history of any ocular surgery like failed trabeculectomy or any kind of intraocular surgeries. Basically, both these non-valve and valve would have some similarities in terms of tube design and plate, but there are a lot of difference also, like different in the size and material of the end plate, presence or absence of any unidirectional valve system. As Madam already told, the AGV has a unidirectional venturi valve system, which prevents the post-operative hypotony and its related complications. But it's also associated with a bleb, encapsulation, hypertensive phases, and inadequate IOP control in sometimes. Whereas in Bearwald and Adi, that's a non-valve, the surgeon has to create a temporary ligature during the surgery, and the IOP has to be continued to be high at least for 4 to 6 weeks post-operatively, and always there is a risk of hypotony. So till the earlier part of this injury, we didn't have much data, but now we have enough evidence about its efficacy and safety. These two large randomized trials, that is AVB and ABC, which agree that both implants were effective in reducing the IOP need for glaucoma medications. But the slightly better results were observed in Bearwald group, that is non-valve group, in terms of IOP reduction and number of anti-glaucoma medication. The similar results were found in our own real data also. So now we have two implants in your hands, almost equal efficacy. So which one has to be preferred? So for that, you need to know some points before choosing your implant. So the most important part is of a parameter is the pre-surgery IOP. If the IOP is very high, even with the maximum number of medication, irrespective of your diagnosis, one should prefer a valved implant. In other scenario, if the IOP is not so high, it may be in high teens or late 20s with even number of maximum medication, one can prefer a non-valved device. Whereas if even the pressure is controlled with maximum number of medication and the patient could not tolerate the topical systemic medications, so one should better to go ahead with a valve devices. So as I already mentioned, ADI always have a risk of hypotony, and we know some of the eyes are more prone for hypotony postoperatively. So to get that, one should know the diagnosis properly. Eyes with inflammation or uveitic glaucoma, One should do a non-valve device very cautiously. Even sometimes patient can present with hypotony in years after surgery. So one should prefer a valve device. Other cases, vitrectomies also have a high tendency for hypotony. So one should prefer a valve devices. Our own data experience that AGV had a good outcome in this subset of eyes. So other conditions like the eyes having pre-existing scleral buckle or scleral tear, it is very difficult to dissect, very difficult to insert a large implant like non-valve devices, and high chance of post-operative tube exposure. But in these eyes, one should prefer valve devices. Other conditions like aphakia also high risk for hypotony, and one should use non-valve device very cautiously. But in case of post-PK, if the eye is pseudophakic or phakic, one can go ahead with the non-valve device. But the way most of the studies said that long-term hypotony can lead to a graft failure. So one should be used cautiously the non-valve devices. So other patient factors like deep-set eye, short eyes, or prominent nasal bridge, in this type of patient, it's very difficult to put a large non-valve devices. One may go with a small valve device like AGV. So other fact, of course, your surgeon's experience and comfort, you should prefer the implant which is more comfortable in your hands. The last note, the least, the cost factor, especially in Indian scenario, we have the Adi which costs around 4 to 6,000, whereas the AGV which costs now more than 20,000. So the cost is a major barrier for opting a valve device in our setup. So in nutshell, so what are the factors to be thought before choosing your implant choice? So first, the underlying etiology, pre-surgery IOP and severity of glaucoma, tolerance of systemic medication, surgeon's comfort and experience, and cost and affordability. So to conclude, as mentioned in various studies, to conclude, the individual patient characteristics, surgeon's comfort, experience with each implant are critical in device selection. The benefit of each implant reducing the IOP must be balanced with the surgical complication associated with. Having said that, even the worst scenario, surgeon may forced to opt a non-valve device in Indian scenario because of most of our patients belong to low socioeconomic background. Thank you, sir, for giving an opportunity.